Hey there, welcome to another ResTech tip. In today's tip, we'll be covering FID maintenance. Now, say you're in a lab running tons of samples a day. Over time, these samples can really start to contaminate your GC system, including the FID. You may experience things like a high baseline, loss in sensitivity, noise peaks, or maybe the flame just won't ignite. Sometimes, your FID can get so dirty that you will be able to notice sample buildup on the inside of the Castle assembly. This is a great indicator that it's time to do some FID maintenance. If you have tried changing the jet, but these problems still persist, then it's time to replace some of the FID parts. This includes the Castle assembly, the upper and lower PTFE insulators, the collector, the rubber housing gasket, and the FID jet. To swap out these parts, first cool the GC, turn off the instrument flow, remove the column from the detector, and cool the FID. Be sure to also turn off all FID gas flows as well. Next, we'll start to disassemble the FID. Remove the igniter and all torque screws from the FID body. Then, remove the knurled brass retaining nut and spring washer. Before replacing the new parts, I like to clean out the FID body with a little bit of methanol. Once this is done, we can replace the Castle, the PTFE insulators, the collector, and the rubber housing gasket. Now that we have replaced these parts, reattach the FID body to the GC and reconnect the igniter to the Castle assembly. Reinstall the column and return the GC and FID to its normal running conditions. Give the FID some time to condition at temperature to help drive off any volatile contaminants. Once this is done, your FID should be as good as new. Thanks for taking the time to watch, but if there's something specific that you would like to see, be sure to drop it in the comments below. Also, throw us a like on our social media pages. We hope you enjoyed this ResTech tip.